So I will talk about the distal points in detail tomorrow. So here I will briefly show you the distal points. Already you are a professional. So for him, during the break, I diagnosis that so he has some stagnation problem and the liver tree stagnation and his face turns red frequently with a inner fire frequently. So it is originated from the liver system. So for him, I will choose Li4 and LV3. So I will do this. So now I washed my hands. So Li4 and ST3. So ST3 is one of my favorite acupoints. Oh, I'm sorry. LV3.
Liver three.
Yeah, liver three. Oh, I will show you this. So for the liver three, we should palpate here too. So I can hold this and LV3, LV2, or between LV3 and three. So I really like this acupoints, and then I will do this here, LV3. So you can use any points you want. based on your diagnosis. For here, I chose only two points, LIVER3 and LI4. So after that, and then now here, I use the 0.20 15 mm needles, but usually for the distal point, I prefer a longer one. So 0.20 30 mm or 0.25 and 30 mm. So after that, and you can pull out the needles immediately or you can retain them for 10 minutes or 15 minutes or even 30 minutes. It's up to you. And then I will pull out the needles. Thank you very much.
No needles on my face?
Ah,
No?
in 10 minutes.
Okay.
That's the reason I'm here for.
So for the acupressure and massage technique, this is just short version of my suggestion. So I know that many of them already have your skill to release the neck area. So you can do this more longer, and you can do even acupuncture or acupressure massage. It's up to you. It's based on your diagnosis. And I will explain a little bit, and then we'll take a break, and then I will show you the needling on the forehead lines and frown lines. So practice three forehead lines and frown lines. This is a suggestion needling for the forehead lines and frown lines. So you can see this needle 0.16, 0.16, and other needles are I used 0.12 mm needles. So, frontalis, procellus, corrugator superciliae, and depressor superciliae are related. The forehead lines, the frontalis contraction folds the skin of the forehead. Yeah, I told you by elevating the eyebrows, resulting in the forehead lines. Typical dynamic horizontal wrinkles strongly related to muscle movement. But when we get older, these dynamic wrinkles also become the static wrinkles. And frown lines, procellus, corrugator superciliae, depressor superciliae, they pull the skin down and toward the nose. this way and this way. So when these three muscles contract, the vertical wrinkles are formed. Forehead lines. To reduce the forehead lines, we should release the tightened frontalis muscle with the needle. So when we do the acupressure and massage on the occiput, yeah, it might be helpful too. So needles on the site of wrinkles help reduce the forehead line by increasing circulation under the skin. So we'll do the acupuncture with the transverse angle on the line, forehead lines. So frontalis, DU24 to vitalize the skin, and GB14. So here, I use the GB14 not for the systemic effect of Qi and Meridian, but for the local effect with needle stimulation for the micro trauma. The skin of the forehead area is relatively thin. So if you do this on this area, pretty painful, the patient say. GB14 is sensitive to pain, so insert the needle gently and only briefly while holding the skin around GB14 with the other hand to keep it from moving. So when you do this at the first, for example, I really want to do the transverse angle insertion, and the depth of insertion should be 10 millimeters. So I do this, but just 5 millimeters, and then patient complained pain. So should I stop now, or should I push the needle more? What do you think?
Stop.
Yes, stop, and then forget it. It's enough. Because already we stimulate the skin tissue 5 millimeters. It's okay. If a patient feels pain, stop the progress and take a moment and check if the pain is gone or not. If the patient feels an ongoing pain, remove the needle. So after we doing the needles here, and then if the patient complains the pain, stop the progressing the needle. You don't need to pull out the needle immediately. So, and then maybe a few seconds, if the patient said, oh yeah, I'm okay, so please retain the needles. But patient said, really hurt, it's worse, worse. At the time, we should pull out the needle. So needling technique, as I several mentioned about this, this is a suggestion. So you don't need to follow this exactly. And then you don't need to be stressed to make this like. So DU24, insert the needle toward the top of the head, 0.16, with the transverse oblique angle, with the length 5 up to 10. Please notice the DU24. So it's not the same angle, same shape. So it's totally different on people, each people. So sometimes we select oblique, or some people transverse, it would be okay. And GB14, Insert the needle toward the lateral side following the eyebrow line. So we can do the needling toward the midline or toward the lateral line, but with my experience, needling toward the midline is more painful. So I recommend needling toward the lateral side is much better. And you don't need to only insert on the GB14 because the forehead line, if you see the patient's lines, some lines, their location is pretty different. So if you try to find the GB14 lines, but the line is more higher than GB14, please forget about GB14. Select the point on the forehead line around GB14 would be enough. So this area will do the local effect with needle stimulation under the skin tissue. So we choose 0.12 millimeter thickness of needles, and the angle is would be transverse. So this is ideal, but you don't need to worry about this. It's just 3 millimeters, 5 millimeters would be okay. And locate the wrinkles by folding the skin. So before the forehead line insertion, I asked the patients, can you make the forehead line? And then I saw, and then I chose and locate. So drawing an imaginary line from GB14 to DU24, insert the needles right beneath the wrinkles on that imaginary line toward the lateral side. But about this, you don't need to focus on it. So you can choose two lines, three lines, four lines, it's up to you. It's up to the patients. But this is the basic, so at least two lines, please select and then put the needles with the transverse angle. And if you put the needles very well, you could see the instant change of it. So sometimes I do this on my face in front of the mirror. But still, me, someday it is not painful at all, but sometimes it didn't progress well. So it's sometimes better and sometimes not good, but it's okay, it's normal.
Sorry, can you explain again the green and the arrow? Yeah, I think I missed it in the
Yeah, thank you
morning.
very
And
much.
the hollow circle and the solid circle.
Yeah, I prepared for legend tomorrow, but I will explain shortly. So green means finest one, 1.12. Red means 0.16. Yeah, so the color of the arrow represents the thickness of needle. Yes, so tomorrow on the masseter area, you will see the blue color of the arrow. It indicates 0.20 millimeters. So I differentiate the thickness of needle with colors. And you can see this arrow shape. Regular is flat, right? Can you guess what is this indicate? Right, yeah, smart. Transverse angle. And regular means oblique. If the insertion angle is transverse oblique, I indicate oblique too, like this. And If I do the perpendicular 90 degrees, I indicate that as a round shape of the arrow. And as you already knew, this circle means point, acupoint. So this like this. Yes. Ah, because this area is white, more white, so I differentiate the round area, but here the hair, so I changed outside the white, yeah, to see better. And frown lines. These are dynamic vertical wrinkles deeply related to habitual facial expression and become static vertical wrinkle with getting older. But you know, with aging for years and years, if these wrinkles become the static wrinkle, and then they will complain about this. So, if the patient said to us, "Oh, my concern is the frown line," it means already it became a static wrinkles. So that's why, oh, I want to erase or reduce the frown lines. The more we frown, the deeper the frown lines are. Okay, let me see. Okay, from the frown lines, I will explain for a little bit and then I will do the needling on the frown lines and forehead lines. So let's take a 15-minute break and I will see you in 15 minutes.
Can I ask you one question before we go on
Yeah,
break on the front
sure.
lines? So if the so only just the GB14 is enough on the face? So if this is So let's say the frown lines like this, right? So one needle would be here, and then the one on the GB14 would just be either this one or this one, you mean?
Yeah, there's this one.
So one going this way,
Yeah.
and then how about this line?
Yeah.
You would do another one
Yeah,
going this way, and then
right.
however many lines they have,
Yeah,
it will be
right.
along the line of GB14 to.
Right,
Okay, so
yeah.
I see.
So usually, yeah, thank you for asking. So this is the midline and eyebrow. And if you see many patients, some people have the parallel to the ground, they have the forehead lines, but some people make like this. So you can see many various different frown lines. So I want you to locate near GB14. It should not always be the GB14 exactly.
It should be on
So
the line.
yeah, so it's like near the line. You can choose, for example, so it's like from the thumb of distance, it would be the GB14 to the middle of a pupil. But if the line if the frown lines like this, I want you to locate this
Right on the line.
on the frown lines and then progress the needle following the lines. So if the line is straight, insert the needle this. But if the line is a little bit curved, it's okay. And then you can choose two, at least two needles, but you can choose three, four, or five, like this line.
I see. Yeah. So what I have seen in the past, what other practitioners do is they don't only pick one line per wrinkle, but they for example, would do this, and another needle like this,
yeah,
and another
okay.
one. So that's fine too?
Yeah, it's okay.
Does that make it stronger, or is not necessary?
So actually, excellent question. In my view, the more needles, the better result.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
Oh, the more, the better. Okay.
Yeah. So we could start at first 20, 25 needles, but step by step, please add a little bit more. So for example, if the patient has the very long, deep frown lines, forehead lines here, this way would be better than just one needle. So today, I want you to see the very basic cosmetic acupuncture. Actually, I want you to know the fundamentals of cosmetic, and then please modify, edit on your way.
Okay, yeah. And then one more question is the gauge of needle. You suggested the two gauges for us. So would you say that if you use all the same gauge, the effect would be similar, or it's better to, if the line is deeper, use a thicker gauge?
Sure.
Or what is your recommendation?
So here I recommend 0.12, but if the, for example, my skin is very dry sensitive. So if my patient is me, I would use 0.12 finest needle. But if the patient's the skin is a little bit oily and a little bit thicker than me and more healthy or it's like 10 years younger than me, I would choose 0.16, absolutely.
I see.
So basically I can say the more needles and thicker needles, the better result. But we choose between the pain, inducing pain and result.
So if your patient can endure pain,
yeah.
then we should choose the thicker needle
right.
for faster result.
Right.
Okay.
So this is a suggestion. Actually, can you see this? Okay. Yeah. So I wrote this book for the beginner cosmetic acupuncture practitioner. So, in this book, I chose like this, 0.12 here, 0.16 here. But this is the basic, so after learning these basic things, you can use, and one more thing. Actually, if you wanted to put the 0.12 millimeters needles here, so you tried, but the needles is easily bent, and then so difficult, you can choose 0.16 or 0.20 instead. So we should choose the needle based on the patient's condition, but practitioners skill and practitioner's purpose would be, I think, more important. Because if we feel comfortable, the patient can get a more effect for us.
So, Dr. Choice, is your book available on Amazon or somewhere?
Yeah, Amazon.com.
Amazon.com.
Yeah.
Donna, can you please put the link for us where to buy the book?
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah, so can I take a break?
Yeah, yeah, break. Sorry.
Okay.
Any questions?
Oh, thank you very much. I will see you in 50 minutes. Thank you, Tina. Really, I
it's very, very,
appreciate
very
it.
clear. But it seems like a lot of work.